Hey guys, welcome back to Xamarin guys. So in this tutorial we are going to customize our cell page. So here you can see our cell flyout has been customized to different icons as well as text orientations, and the bottom bar is presented with different icons that were taken out from Material Design Icons, which is a free open source. You can take those icons and download it. Now let's extract our downloaded file from our downloads folder. This is our zip file. We need to extract it, and after extracting we'll get our folder over here, and then this is our main .ttf file which we need to call inside icon fonts to code. This is the conversion of our icon font. So you need to browse through the same file that you have downloaded previously. So this is the file location where I have downloaded the file. I will copy that given location and then paste it over here to the browser source location. Now after it gets loaded up, it will be presented with different icons. Here you can see each icon can get converted to code if clicked. So we have lots of icons over here. So we can convert those icons to code and use it freely inside our application. So we are going to copy that .ttf file that we have downloaded to resources folder of iOS and assets folder of Android at first. So we are going to copy that .ttf file inside resources folder of iOS and assets folder of Android. That's all. Now we are going to configure our info.plist, and I'm going to edit it with XML text editor. Then this line of code will tell that we are going to use this material design icon wavefont.ttf file, and then we'll be extracting our icons from this file using the code which we converted from icon font to code web browser. So that's all from the iOS point of view. And in Android project there is no any special configuration that need to be done. At first we are going to tell that AppCell is my cell page that gets navigated after our application starts. So in order to create a new cell page, you need to add a new page as your content page and name it as AppCell. After adding a new content page, you will be presented over here as a content page. You need to change it to cell, and in its code behind too, you need to inherit from cell. That's all. Now our content page has been completely transformed into a cell page. Here I have added three properties that are flyout background image, flyout background image aspect, and flyout behavior as flyout. You can disable this flyout. You can see over here, this is our flyout. Then we can disable that too, but our main objective is to present that with background image. So this is our background image which has an aspect fill and which has been stored inside resources folder of both Android as well as iOS. So this is our image that was called as an aspect fill so that it can fill whole area of that flyout. That's all. Now I have downloaded one image randomly from internet, and then this is another icon image that will be used inside our header template. I'll be telling that where I'm going to use those two images inside our cell page. So here you can see we have created one header template which will be called inside our flyout whenever it is presented. So this is our header template content view. In order to create a content view, create a new item, then select a content view and then rename it to header template and then add it. So inside our header template .xaml, here inside our content view we have height request of 170. That is our, this content view is going to be of height 170, and then I'll give all the code in the description below. You can copy paste that code. Now our first image, that is This image is going to be called at the background of our header template, and then this is the same icon that is going to be called, and this is the text that will be presented inside our header template. That's all. So this is our code behind of header template.cs, which is inheriting from content view. That's all inside our header template.xaml. Now let's get back to our appsale.xaml. After we have added our header template, now it's time to change our flyout icon. So this is our flyout icon that need to be changed instead of default hamburger icon. So this line of code is going to change that hamburger icon to our expected icons that need to be added over there. So in order to do that, inside our app.xaml, I have as material font. So the file that we have downloaded previously inside resources folder of iOS and assets folder of Android will be called with the help of this line of code. That's all. After calling those two files, then we are going to connect our this app.xaml to our views, that is our appsale.xaml, using static resource. So let's go to our appsale.xaml, and then you can see over here the font family will inherit that key from our app.xaml. So changing this glyph will change our icons. So this is the code that need to be passed inside that TTF file that we have downloaded it previously. So from our icon fonts to code, we can clearly see each icons with the code. So I'm going to select this icon, and after F, we need to take that text area and then paste it after X. So you will get as expected icons. You can bind those icons. If you want to send those icons from your code behind, then you need to use the same code that was generated from web URL, then bind those image with that. You can see over here, I have added two tab bar inside our first flyout item as flyout item with tab, and then another flyout item without tab. So it contains only one tab. That's why if I click on this, then it will never be presented with tab. So at first menu with tab, it contains foreground color as white, flyout icon. You can see over here, it has different icons. That's why we are going to add those icon from here, icon codes. And after X, we need to add those icon name, and these are the properties that has been attached to our first flyout item, and it contains two tabs. You can see over here, this first menu with tab, it contains two tabs with different icons. Now let's go to menu without tab. Here I have added only one tab inside our flyout item, and these are the properties that has been attached it with. That's all. Now inside our another flyout item as multiple items, you can see over here, if I add about as our multiple item, then one bar will be displayed. Then I'm going to attach it with a new page, that is main page. You can change those pages. This is inside my local. So I have added settings to inherit that same page inside our app sale. Then at last, I'm going to attach item template for our flyout item. That means I'm going to create one theme where all the flyout icons as well as titles will be changed with respect to this theme. So there are two labels, that is first label will denote the binding icons that were present inside the flyout item, and the second one is the label that will contain the title. So the flyout icon as well as the title is going to be binded with our item template. That's all. I'll give that code in the description below. You can grab that code. That's all for this tutorial now. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Keep in touch for next tutorials.